Good morning, students. Today we shall start the third chapter of the mathematics of class 12 syllabus. So the third chapter is matrices. So what is matrices? It is a rectangular arrangement of numbers or functions. A matrix is an ordered rectangular array of numbers or functions. These numbers may be real or complex numbers, or it may be of functions also. So this arrangement is called matrix, and this matrix can be denoted with the uppercase letters of English alphabet, say like A, B, C, D, etc. And this arrangement, it should be enclosed by a square bracket. So we can write a matrix A, say, it can use numbers, real, complex, or functions, anything, say 5, 2, 1, minus 4. So, this way you can arrange. So, in this, if we write this way, in that, we can see that arrangement, it has rows and columns. Horizontal lines are rows and vertical lines are called columns. So these rows and columns determines the order. What is the order of the matrix? So here, how many rows are there? 1 and 2 rows are there. And how many columns are there? 2 columns are there. So order of the matrix is 2 by 2. When you read, it should be read as 2 by 2. And while writing, it is 2 into 2. But reading time, it is 2 by 2. So this order, it may be of any order. It may be say m rows and n columns. So the first order is number of rows, and second one is number of columns. First one indicates number of rows, second one indicates number of columns. And each these numbers are called elements of the matrix. Here this one is an element. These all are elements of the matrix. Clear? Now, any matrix, say another matrix, say A, it may have, say M rows and N columns. So it may be M by N. And each element also we can denote is a rectangular one. Rectangular. Here it is, if you see, it is 2 by 2, so it is also a square matrix. But it may be of rectangular, it may be of only with rows also, or only with columns also. So if it is only with rows, these are types of matrices we will be going next. So here, if there are m number of rows and n number of columns, each element we can express, say this one is A11. Why this 1, 1 I have written? First one is for row, second one is for column. So like that, A12, A13, it may be like that, A1, how many? It is columns, how many? N. Okay? So in this way, first row it is. First row, so first one is indicating the rows. So it is 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, up to 1, n. Second one will be A, 2, 1, because it is second row and this is first column. It will be A, 2, 2, A, 2, 3, like that it may be A, 2, n. Similarly, it may be of next one will be A31, 32, 33, like that, up to 3n. If you go like that, say it is AM1, means m number of rows and this is the first column. So M1, A, M2, A, M3, like that if it goes on, it is AMN. Last one will be M rows and it is nth column. So it is of M by N matrix. And this, all this one, if we want to write in a very small way, short way, it can be written that way also. It is A I J. I J. This I J means I is the row and J is the column. So here we write this order. What is that? It is M by N and I is from 1 to M and J is from 1 to N. So I and J belongs to the natural number. It is counting numbers. It is starting from 1 to M or 1 to N. So it is all natural number. So this will indicate this I, how many it will be. It is up to M and J is up to N numbers. N natural numbers. Clear? Okay. Next we will see the types of matrices. So next we will see the types of matrices. In that types of matrices, there are different types of matrices are there. First one is the column matrix. What is column matrix? If a matrix has only one column, it, say example we give, if a matrix or definition if you write it, column matrix is a matrix which has only one column, then it is called column matrix. So if we write only in columns, so any numbers you can write, so 5, 1, 2, it has only one column. So it has how many rows? It has 3 rows but only one column. So it is 3 by 1. So it is called column matrix. It may be of any number of rows but only one column, then it is called column matrix. Is it clear? Next comes row matrix. What is row matrix? A matrix is said to be a row matrix if it has only one row. You can see, you can take another example of row matrix. The matrix B, it has only one row. Any elements can be, by writing the elements, you should keep little gap between the elements. So if you look here, it has only one row, elements are minus 1, 5, 2, 4. Here, the row is only 1. So what will be the order of this matrix? It is 1 by how many columns now? 1, 2, 3, 4 columns. So it is 1 by 4. Its order is 1 by 4. So it is called row matrix. A matrix is called row matrix if it has only one row. Next comes square matrix. What is called square matrix? And this is a very important matrix in all the matrices. Square matrix means its arrangement must be in a square way. Means its number of rows and number of columns must be equal. A matrix is said to be a square matrix if the number of rows and number of columns are equal in the matrix, then it is called a square matrix. So it can be of 2 by 2, 3 by 3, 4 by 4 or M by N. It may be of any order. You can take an example of a square matrix. Square matrix. The matrix C. So, if you see this here element is, how many rows are there? 2 rows. And how many columns are there? 2 columns. So it is of 2 by 2. So it is a square matrix of order 2. When you say square matrix, it means its number of rows and number of columns are equal. So you can say it is a square matrix of order 2. It may be of another example. Another example. In this case, there are number of rows are 3 rows and number of columns are 3 columns. So it is a square matrix of order 3 and its order is 3 by 3. So like that, square matrix can be of any order, but number of rows and number of columns must be equal. So it is called a square matrix. Next, diagonal matrix. What is called diagonal matrix? In a diagonal matrix, it must be a square matrix. Here all these matrices, they must be of square matrix. Okay? So a square matrix is said to be a diagonal matrix if diagonal elements are different and other elements, other than diagonal elements. So if we take the example here, diagonal elements, so this is called diagonal, these are diagonal, other elements must be 0 and diagonal elements are non-zero. If only this is the main diagonal, so this diagonal elements must be non-zero. So what is called diagonal matrix? A diagonal matrix is a square matrix whose non-diagonal elements are 0. If you want to write, it is a 2 by 2 diagonal matrix. Okay? So if you write 3 by 3, here all that non-diagonal elements, these are non-diagonal elements. If these elements are 0, then it is called diagonal matrix. Now, these diagonal elements may be any numbers. So this is called diagonal matrix. It is a diagonal matrix of 3 by 3. It must be a square matrix. Next comes, what is scalar matrix? Scalar. You know about scalar quantity, vector quantity. So what is scalar? Scalar means numbers. So what is called scalar matrix? A square matrix is said to be a scalar matrix if its diagonal elements are same. So here it is 5. Here also it must be 5. Then it is called scalar matrix. Non-diagonal elements will be remaining as 0. Okay? Or you can say a diagonal matrix is said to be a scalar matrix if its diagonal elements are same. In this, here also if you write, say it is 2, whatever it is, then it is called scalar matrix. Clear? Is it clear now, scalar matrix? Next is unit matrix. Unit means 1. So what is called unit matrix? A square matrix or a scalar matrix is said to be unique, or a diagonal matrix is said to be unique if its diagonal elements are 1. If its diagonal elements are 1 and non-diagonal elements will be 0. If diagonal elements are 1 only, then it is called unit matrix. And it is also, you can denote it by the letter capital I. Also it can be denoted. Here it can be written, these elements will be how much? All the elements must be 1. Diagonal elements must be 1. Then it is called unit matrix of order 3. All these matrices must be a square matrix. So a square matrix is said to be unit matrix if its diagonal elements are 1. Okay? Next is called, what is called zero matrix. So zero matrix means its all the elements will be of 0. It must be a square matrix. But here all the elements of this matrix will be 0. If all the elements are 0. And this 0 matrix can be denoted with the letter capital O. In the letter capital O also can be denoted. All the elements are 0. Then it is called 0 matrix. Is it clear? More types of matrices are there. We will be discussing the next. So here up to 7 types I have written. Up to 0 matrix. Next, triangular matrix, upper triangular matrix, lower triangular matrix, symmetric matrix, skew symmetric matrix. There are different types are there. We will be discussing next. It comes equality of matrices. When two matrices are said to be equal. So, equality of matrices. Two matrices are said to be equal if they have same order. Their order must be same. If this is of order 2 by 2, this also must be of order 2 by 2. If it is of other order, say 2 by 3, this also must be of 2 by 3. They must have same order, and also their elements, their corresponding elements must be identical. Two matrices are said to be equal if they have same order and the corresponding elements are identical. So here I have written matrix A is x 5 minus 2 1 and matrix B is 3 5 minus 2 and y. So these two matrices you can say equal. Well, if when they will be equal, if x, this x, here x I have written, it is an unknown number. So it must be a number. So what is that number? If we, when we can say A equal to B, if A is equal to B, we can say matrix A is equal to matrix B. If, when, then x must be how much? If you compare these two, x must be, corresponding elements must be identical. Means it must be same. So x must be equal to 3, then x will be equal to 3. 5 is same, minus 2 is same, then here 1 and here it is y. So y must be how much? Y must be 1. Then x is equal to 3 and y is equal to 1. If a is equal to b, then this is. Now if x is equal to 3 and y is equal to 1, then also you can say the two matrices are equal. It may be of any order, but orders must be same and their corresponding elements must be identical. Clear? Next it comes. Can we add two matrices, or when can we add two matrices? Two or more matrices can we add? Yes, we can add the matrices if they have of same order. Their order must be same. Then we can add two matrices, means corresponding elements we can add, okay, or we can subtract also if they have of same order. So here if we want to see what is A plus B, if A is the matrix 5 5 minus 2 1, B is the matrix 3 5 minus 2 4, then can we add these two matrices? Yes. So what will be the matrix? Their order must be same, so the corresponding elements we can add. So it will be 5 plus 3, next element it is 5 plus 5, next element it is minus 2 plus minus 2, and it is 1 plus 4. So what will be the elements? What will be this result? It will be 8, this is 10, this is minus 4 and 5. So this is the addition of matrices. Okay? Like that we can add more matrices also. Other matrices also, if it is there, along with that A, B, C, we can add also. Or we can subtract also. What will be A minus B? If we want to find what is subtraction, if we want to find subtraction, A minus B, then what will happen? In place of plus, it will become minus. It will be 5 minus 3, 5 minus 5 minus 2 minus minus 2 means plus 2 and 1 minus 4. So what will be the result? 5 minus 3 is 2, 5 minus 5 is 0, minus 2 plus 2 again 0, and 1 minus 4 is minus 3. So we can subtract those. Now, can we multiply with a scalar? Any matrix, can we? Addition and subtraction also we have seen. Subtraction. Now, can we multiply a matrix with a scalar? Yes, that also we can do. So what will be if we multiply with a scalar? It is A. A is the matrix. So what will be say? 3A. 3A means by 3 you have to multiply each element. So it is, it will be 3 into 5. Here also it is 3 into 5, 3 into minus 2, and 3 into 1. Okay? So like that, it is a scalar, it is called scalar multiplication of matrices. You can multiply any matrix with a scalar. It can be of any scalar number, it can be of negative number also, it can be of positive number also. With any number you can, with a scalar you can multiply the matrix. Now if you want to find, say two matrices are given, you have to find 2a minus 3b. Can we find? Yes, we can find. So 2 into a minus 3 into, with minus 3 will do it. So 2 into a, so 2 into a is 5, 5 minus 2, 1, and minus 3 into b is 3, 5 minus 2, 4. So what will be the result? This matrix, it will be 10, 10, minus 4 and 2, and minus 3 into this one, so it is 3 into 3, 9, 15, it is minus 6 and 12. So now can you subtract? Yes, you can subtract now. 10 minus 9, then 10 minus 15, so what will be the result? Because it is of same order, you can subtract. So 10 minus 9 is 1, this is 1, 10 minus 15 is minus 5, minus 4, minus, minus 6, so it is plus 6, minus 4, it is 2, and 2 minus 12, it is minus 10. So this way also we can find out the values of different values with a scalar multiplication and addition and subtraction. Thank you for today.